And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek 25th Anniversary Blind. I'm the RPG chick.
Hijacked.
Beginning the second episode, Hijacked. Of course.
Message from Starfleet, Captain.
On screen, Lieutenant.
The USS Enterprise is to report immediately to Beta Myamid. The USS Masada has failed to report as scheduled. Determine nature of delay and take whatever measures are necessary.
Set course for Beta Myamid, sir.
Beta Myamid, okay. So, let me just check my map, or my screenshot of a map, which is somewhere. Where is Beta Myamid is 15. Okay, so that's 16, 15, hopefully. Otherwise, we get into battle.
There is an unidentified ship closing rapidly. Weapons on and shields up.
Raising shields.
Arming weapons.
Message coming in, sir.
On screen, Lieutenant.
Leave the Beta Myamid system immediately. You're interfering in Alasi affairs.
We are conducting a search and rescue mission for the USS Masada. It was last reported in this system. We cannot leave until we can confirm its location and condition.
So be it. You have been warned. Prepare to die.
Oh, great. Where are they? Ah, I see them. Oh, they're flying around a lot. Got you at least once. I saw him. I'd like to go to full screen, but I need the radar. Did he even damage us? Doesn't appear so. What's his analysis?
Target analysis off.
He's a little damaged.
Target analysis off.
I keep it off so we can see how we're doing. Is he running now? I'd be happy if I ever hit with a photon torpedo. Oh, they're so fast. Gotcha. We're still fine, aren't we? That should have hit.
They are free.
Good.
The enemy ship's initial intercept course was from the last known position of the Masada. I suggest we orbit the planet for a closer sensor scan, sir.
Sounds good to me. Orbit.
There she is, Captain. She does not appear to be seriously damaged. Her shields are up, and 27 life forms are aboard.
Huh. What do we do now? Can we communicate?
Hailing the ship, Captain.
There we go.
Greetings, Federation Imperialists. I am Alasi Seren, and I have claimed this ship as a blow for freedom against Federation tyranny.
I don't want to talk to you.
This is Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise. You are illegally in possession of Starfleet property.
Wait, was that the Masada attacking us? I thought it was another ship.
This is Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise. Listen, Alasi. Hand over the ship and hostages now, or things are going to get very nasty.
Pretty cool, but I think choice one is better.
This is Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise. Mr. Alasi, it appears that you have found something the Starfleet lost.
Yeah, let's be all business.
This is Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise. You are illegally in possession of Starfleet property.
Ah, the infamous Captain Kirk.
Thanks.
The Masada is mine. You will release 25 political prisoners I specify, or I will destroy the ship and its crew. The list of those wrongfully imprisoned should be coming over to you now.
Data file captured, Captain. Computer indicates they were all convicted of piracy with various counts of murder and mayhem thrown in.
Freeing the prisoners you requested will take time. We have to track down their current locations, and Starfleet will have to grant permission to move them here. I will get that started. You should tender a show of good faith on your part. Will you beam over so we can discuss negotiations face to face?
Well, I wish I knew if that was bluffing or not. Or stalling him. I don't deal with terrorists. I just put them away.
We can work together on this, Alasi. How about beaming some of the hostages over as a show of good faith?
Oh, I like that one.
Freeing the prisoners you request. We can work together on this, Alasi.
This one.
How about beaming some of the hostages over as a show of good faith?
What? Lower my shield so you can beam over a war party? I'm not stupid, Captain. We'll play by my rules.
This mouth stop
moving.
So long
as the shields are up, Captain, our hands are tied.
The Enterprise can overpower the Masada and take her, but the pirates would have all the time they need to kill every one of the hostages.
Will you send over data on the whereabouts and conditions of my falsely accused clansmen languishing in your dungeons, Captain?
Very well, we'll do it your way. I will put together the data packet. Kirk out.
Well.
Your fellow Alasi have been tried in Federation courts of law and found guilty of their crimes. We'll listen to your complaints if you discuss them reasonably.
I like that one.
Forget it, Alasi Sereth. You'll be the next one languishing on a Federation penal planet unless you drop your shields and surrender to me immediately.
Choice two.
Your fellow Alasi have been tried in Federation courts of law and found guilty.
These hostages are being tried by the Alasi justice system. You have the final say, Captain, whether they receive the death penalty or not. Alasi Sereth out.
Oh, what the hell do we do now? Let's confer with Mr. Spock.
Captain, we could use the command prefix code to lower the Masada's shields briefly, long enough for one transporter burst.
Oh, that's right. This is our ship. We know the codes. To beam over... how many?
Captain, we could use the command prefix code to lower the Masada's shields briefly, long enough for one transporter burst.
What is that, five people? Six people? I forget how many you could beam down on the original Enterprise. How do we send a prefix? Send a prefix code, Hail Masada. Send a prefix code. I don't know what the code is. Is it on the map? Yeah, I don't know what that is.
That code had no effect, Captain.
That's repair.
I don't know how long she can take it, Captain.
May I respectfully remind the Captain that we...
What does this do?
Captain's log.
Cool. We got points. Computer. Masada.
Masada, USS. A Federation tug tender. Registry NCC-293391. Currently under the command of Captain Kevin Keeler. Crew complement of 17.
Primary kidding
mission,
me?
Tow repair of disabled ships. Its input override code is 293391-197736-3829.
Yeah, I didn't get all that. I'm gonna make us type all that in.
Masada, USS. A Federation tug tender. Registry NCC 293391. Currently under the command of Captain Kevin Keeler. Crew complement of 17. Primary okay. mission.
Prefix code. This one, okay. Now, when it says prefix code, is this the prefix? Or do I have to type the whole code, actually? 293391.
That code had no effect, Captain.
It would be the whole thing, then, I guess. It's just, I don't know why it's called a prefix code. But it isn't called a prefix code when the computer tells us about it. 293391 1977 36 3829.
Sending prefix and lowering the Masada shields.
Nice. Now what?
Disarming weapons.
Oh, why are we doing that?
Arming weapons.
We have to lower our own shields, though.
Lowering shields, Captain.
How do I get people on board?
May I respectfully remind...
Oh, this one.
Spock, come with me. Mr. Scott, you have the con.
I forget who takes that, you know, command. Whatever you want to call it. Right, so we're not beaming people aboard. It makes sense just to beam ourselves aboard. Besides, that would be boring, not being able to look around the ship and stuff. So by the way, guys, I'm going to be doing... like, one episode is going to be one play session, right? And I'm going to split it up into roughly 30-minute chunks so as to keep the episodes separate. Alright, well, let's, talk. Look.
Lieutenant Christensen stands ready.
No, we don't have Everett this time.
James T. Kirk cautiously watches the area. McCoy wonders how many patients he'll have on this mission. Spock quietly analyzes the damaged areas of this transporter room.
When this operation is complete, Captain, we should have Mr. Scott or Transporter Chief Kyle come here to assist with the repairs.
Let's not look too far ahead, Mr. Spock.
I do agree, though.
Well, Jim, there's one thing I can tell you. I don't like Alasi.
I can't see them winning any popularity contests, Bones.
They can forget about my vote.
Nah.
Get what you can from this area. Let's get moving.
Captain, a thorough analysis is required.
Okay, but let's not stay too long in one place.
Will something bad happen if I stay too long in one place?
This is just like their raid on Damocles Station. Hard, fast, and dirty.
Alright, let's look at everything.
The transporter bay has been damaged in a recent firefight. The transporter bay. A small bomb appears to have damaged the transporter controls.
A bomb?
The transporter bay. The transporter bay. The transporter bay has been. This man was obviously the transporter engineer. He is unconscious, but alive.
I plan on reviving him.
The transporter bay has been. These doors have been scarred by phaser fire. There was a battle here.
Indeed there was.
The transporter bay... The transporter bay has been...
Analyze... stuff.
I believe this would be in Dr. McCoy's field of expertise. I am registering energy residue from phaser fire and phaser grenade detonations. There are readings of another energy weapon, but the type is unknown.
Wait a second, there are phaser grenades? I didn't know that.
Even our most efficient chief engineer, Scott, would have trouble repairing this damage in less than 2 days.
Check him out.
He's not hurt badly. I can revive him.
Okay, so for that, we would choose this.
Thank you, Doctor. Be careful, Captain. The Alasi like to set booby traps. If you need any equipment, I've got my tools in this workspace.
Not the best voice acting. What we got here?
A Runcinate transmogrifier, an engineering tool used in the maintenance of transporters, which can be fitted with bits having a variety of irregularly serrated surfaces.
Hmm.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Nothing? We're not on it?
Nothing to report, Captain.
Okay. Get the thing. First walk into a wall, then get the thing. Alright, what can we do with this?
Captain, I need to find a bit that will fit into the transmogrifier before I can go further with this.
Okay. Can we get these things?
I don't think he should be moved, Jim.
Trying to get him.
Well, at least I'm not picking up residue of any biological weapons. The Alasi used some restraint, if you can call it that.
Oh, I have him selected. Oh, so I can make other people pick up things?
Well, at least I'm not...
I'm not... Okay.
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Alright, that's cool. I didn't know we could have different people pick up things.
There is nothing at the moment for me to...
Alright.
When this operation is complete...
Let's not look too...
Talk to the guy.
I suppose I should be grateful to see anyone after that. I thought I was dead.
Well, with any luck, you won't have to worry about that for quite some time.
Provided the Alasi don't have anything to say about it.
True, true.
Crewman Simpson.
Indeed.
He will be all right, but we shouldn't move him.
Okay. So since it doesn't appear we can get any of this stuff here, or do anything with anything, this is the get thing.
You fail to obtain anything.
Can't get these items.
You fail to obtain anything.
We fail to obtain anything.
You fail to obtain anything.
What about stuff here?
You fail to obtain anything.
One more time.
You fail to obtain...
Thank you. Alright, let's, Well, I'm gonna save first.
Save new game.
That's how he looked to the side. He's like, ooh, we saved. Alright, let's head this way. Can't we head that way? You're kidding me, is this a one... Wait, here we go. I thought it was a one-room puzzle for a second.
Spock is analyzing the surroundings.
Such a weird voice.
You are James Tiberius Kirk, Cap... Lieutenant Christensen is carefully watching the hallway. McCoy is fidgeting around.
Stop fidgeting, Bones.
I don't think we can bring down that force field, Captain. If we could, though, it might be less risky than trying to transport onto the bridge.
There's a force field.
This is a mess now, isn't it?
My daddy would have sent me to bed without supper if I'd done something like this.
This corridor provides access to the transporter room, Captain. It is secure.
Can't say I like the decor.
All right, let's look at everything.
This view screen communication terminal has been damaged beyond repair.
What the hell is this stuff?
A tangle of mangled equipment reduced to junk. There are the remains of 5 phasers without power packs, a drain phaser welder, and scraps of wire and uncertain bits of metal junk. You are in a typical starship corridor. You are in a typical starship. You are in a typical star. You are in a typical starship. Some kind of force field appears to cover the door.
Oh, I got a force field. That's what he was talking about.
You are in a typical.
What's this yellow thing?
You are in a typical starship.
Nothing. Okay. Analyze stuff.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Strong electromagnetic readings come from the doorway at the far end of the hallway. Strong electromagnetic... 5 phasers without power packs, a drained phaser welder, insulation, and bits of wire, and droplets of cooled molten metal.
All the fine details, huh? Can I get anything? Oh, we can get something. What we got? A whole bunch of crap.
You fail to obtain anything.
Anything else we can get?
You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain anything.
What about this crap?
You fail to obtain... You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain...
Alright.
You fail to obtain any...
Anything? What do we have? We got all this crap. What is this? I want to analyze this stuff.
Nothing happens.
How do I put this stuff together? Look at this.
Some scraps of metal found in the corridors of the Masada. Some scraps of wire found in the corridors of the Masada.
Scraps of metal, scraps of wire.
A phaser welder. It is without power. These weapons are powerless, having been shorn of their power packs. The Runcinate transmogrifier. This device was invented by an engineer with a sense of humor about names. With the proper attachments, engineers use it for temporary fixes on key circuits.
So, let's try to attach the thing to the thing. Nothing seems to be happening to anything. What if I burn stuff?
Jim, stop trying to shoot everything. You're making me nervous.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
I don't know if I can attach it to anything in my inventory.
Nothing happens.
Did I look at this thing? Did I have him look at this?
A force field of unusual configurations has been erected in front of the doorway, which leads into the bridge. I don't think it would be healthy to approach too closely, Captain.
I don't suppose just shooting it would work. Oh. Probably won't work though. Stun?
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
What are we doing?
The controls have been virtually destroyed, Captain.
Can they be repaired, Spock?
With Chief Engineer Scott's assistance, I believe we could get them in perfect working order in 2 days.
Spock, we don't have 2 days. If we can repair the transporter, we might be able to transport onto the bridge and capture the Alasi.
I can attempt to jury-rig repairs if I can find parts. However, there is only a 67.357% probability of success.
I've always been a gambler, Spock. Figure out what you'll need.
All right, maybe we need to have him selected. He put the wires on. I thought he was starting to do something.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Do I have the wires? Or the other thing? It's gotta be right there.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Ay, ay, ay.
Nothing happens.
Violence will not solve our current situation, sir.
Well, at least I'm not picking up residue of any biological weapons. The Alasi used some restraint, if you can call it that. Damn it, Jim, I'm a doctor, not a rocket scientist.
Cool.
Phaser welder is now charged.
Oh, what'd I do? I charged it with my phaser. Okay, cool. So now I can weld things.
The wire scraps are too small. They melt instead of fusing together, and you're left with nothing.
Well, that's great.
I think that does it. A comb bit for the transmogrifier. Now I can continue repairs on the transporter controls.
I thought it was transmogrifier. Transmogrifier. Oh, so what is this? I mean, I know what he just told us.
A comb bit. This metal device looks like it fits into something else.
Is he gonna do it, or do I have to go comb bit?
The parts fit together satisfactorily.
Excellent.
The Runcinae transmogrifier fitted with a comb bit, an important engineering tool.
He does say transmogrifier. Well, everyone else says transmogrifier. He says transmogrifier. All right, let's head back then. We didn't have to do that in here, right? Get to work, Mr. Spock.
I attach these here. Now, all I need is a spare length of wiring.
We have something left, don't we? Like that? I destroyed it. Kidding.
Nothing happens.
I burnt the wires? What? Where am I? What do I have? I need the stuff. Oh, that was easy. Now, I believe I get points for looking at everything and stuff.
This view screen... Some kind of force field appears... You are in a typical starship corridor.
And having people analyze things.
A force field of unusual... Nothing to report. Strong electromagnetic...
Okay. Now, how did I do this?
Phaser welder is now charged.
That was just some random thing I tried to. Wait. Didn't I weld it first? Weld that.
I think that does it. A comb bit.
Comb bit. Why do we need a comb bit? Wait. Wrong thing. Getting the welder mixed up with the transmogrifier. This goes on here.
The parts fit together satisfactorily.
Alright, now we leave the room. Is it? I don't get out of here. Thank you.
Nothing happens.
Oh, not the welder, this thing.
I attach these here. Now, all I need is a spare length of wiring.
I can't believe the game left us in an unwinnable situation. I mean, maybe we could have gone back and get more wiring, I don't know.
The bits are not long enough. I need a longer piece of wire.
Oh, that's not even it. Alright, we need wire. Can we get this wire?
You fail to obtain anything.
How about the wire hanging down?
You fail to obtain...
There's wires all over the place, man.
You fail to obtain anything.
This long wire?
You fail to obtain anything.
What if I aim it here?
You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain...
Okay, I guess in the other room. How about this wire?
You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain any...
I think it might be in here.
You fail to obtain...
No. Need wire. Wire. Oh, hello. I never realized we could go there.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Probably shouldn't have killed him. Maybe just stunned him. I am evil. What are these?
Only the red beret of the Alasi guard remains. Only the red beret of the Alasi...
How sad.
You are in the brig of the Masada. Nine of the crew members are held in the cell. The berets of two dead Alasi guards litter the floor.
I didn't even see this door.
You are in the brig of the Masada. You are in the brig of the... You are in the brig of the Masada. You are on the brig of the Masada.
So there's nothing to look at. How about this control?
This appears to be the button that turns the brig force field on and off. This door leads back to the main corridor. Kirk seems concerned by what he sees in this room.
Well, he should be.
Spock raises an eyebrow.
He always does that.
Lieutenant Christensen is fumbling for his phaser. McCoy is looking at the guards.
What guards? There are no longer any guards.
I see that the Alasi live up to their reputation, Captain.
They've turned this freighter into a prison barge.
I'm just a security officer, sir.
I don't like the looks of this, Jim.
You count too, Ensign Christensen.
Captain, the switch has been booby-trapped to detonate a bomb, presumably inside the brig somewhere. Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report. Nothing to report, Captain.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Okay, fuse stuff.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
The crew is tired and has elevated signs from extreme stress, but they will survive.
Yeah, if we get them out of there. What's this little bit here?
A bomb located just inside the force field.
Analyze the bomb.
A medium-strength phaser bomb. The brig force field would contain the explosion, but it would kill the crew members within the cell. I recommend that we find a way of disarming it, Captain.
Can I take these things?
You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain...
I think we should save again before we blow up this bomb.
Save new game.
Alright, can I do anything here?
You are in the brig of the Masada.
Nope.
Nothing happens.
Captain, if we could manage to overload the force field, it would probably detonate the bomb before we could rescue the crewmen.
Right. Can you mess with
wires?
Nothing
happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. You've set off some type of booby trap. The force field protected you from the blast, but everyone inside the brig is dead.
And that's why I say, folks. Yes, yeah, unacceptable. You Spock.
There. I believe the bomb is now defused, Captain.
You're so smart.
These wires look like a modification of some sort.
Oh, we didn't even use the wires we have there.
I see that the Alasi live up to their reputation, Captain.
Okay, so we used him on the wires. He said the bomb will not go off. Let's deal with this. Hey, hey.
Thank you for freeing us, Captain. We'll secure the area so they don't come up behind you. We've had electrical problems with our door to our bridge, Captain. The Alasi don't know we put an electric shutdown device. You'd never find it by chance. But if you used a charged phaser welder 2 feet to the left of the door and 1 foot off the ground, you might be able to shut down the force field and get a jump on the Alasi.
2 feet to the left and 1 meter up? Is that where the controls are?
You are in the brig of the Miss.
I can't even look at this guy.
Thank you for freeing us. You better take the bridge before they suspect anything is up. You'd better hurry up, or they'll catch on, sir.
You get no response.
I guess we have to hurry up. I don't know how to make him run. 2 feet. Phaser welder.
The field is absorbing the energy. The field is absorbing the energy. That did it. The field is deactivated, Captain.
See? For a captain, I'm pretty good at following orders, aren't I? I think we should save again.
Save new game. Replace pre-
Entree. Hi. Do I just open fire, or do I speak with these guys?
The Alasi clan member glares at the party.
He's not even looking at us.
The Alasi clan... This is a standard Starfleet bridge. Perhaps not as impressive as the one on the Enterprise. There are quite a few pirates here.
This lady sounds like she's half asleep.
The Alasi clan member glares... This is a standard Star... He doesn't seem to be in a talkative mood right now.
Yeah.
I'm just a security officer, sir.
So secure things.
Jim, that man is mad.
Spock, nothing to say?
Jim, that man is mad. Jim, that man is mad. Jim, that man is mad.
I'm trying to click off of it. Nothing to say for Mr. Spock.
It's over, Sereth. Surrender, and I'll guarantee the lives of you and your crew.
That one sounds pretty good.
Freeze. Don't even think about it.
I like that one, too.
Check and mate, Alasi. Don't do anything foolish. It's over, Sereth. Surrender, and I'll guarantee the lives of you and your crew.
Let's go with that one.
You are an honorable and worthy opponent, Kirk. I accept your offer.
Scotty, beam down a security team to the bridge. We have regained control. Mr. Scott, beam us out of here.
This is the end?
Captain.
Those goggles look like googly eyes. Like he's looking straight ahead.
Message from Starfleet, Captain.
How do we
do? On screen, Lieutenant.
We have read your report on the problems at Beta Mayanid and evaluate your performance at 80%.
Probably could have killed them.
You and your crew received 2 commendation points. Well done, Captain. Keep up the good work.
Trying to hold a Federation starship captive. Can you believe it?
That was a short
Since
one.
We just witnessed that very event, Doctor. I'm surprised you ask.
It was a rhetorical question, Spock.
That took quite a bit of organization to seize a starship. Think we'll see more of the Alasi pirates?
Undoubtedly, Captain.
Undoubtedly.
I suspect they have considerable resources to draw on.
So do I. Sulu, take us out of here.
Especially now that he said that. I'm sure we'll see more of them. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, which will be...
Love's labor jeopardized.
Endure. Enduring, grow strong.